thought about it, and I was just thinking, why would I be struggling with temptation at the age of 4, 5, 6, 7? And I just came to notice that all I was doing at those ages was completely wrong. I thought I could be a Christian, be forgiven at the same time, and just live my life like everybody else did, like the people in Corinthia. They thought it was perfectly fine to live a life of sin, to live a life of depression, until Paul came and said, no, you can't do that. And so it came until I realized at that moment, at a basketball practice, which I never expected this to happen to me, because I thought I was going to be a perfect person. I noticed all the sin I was doing in my life and all the wrong that happened to me. So I felt at that time, God came to my heart and said, come back to me, rededicate your life to me, don't be a sinner like you were before. And after that, I just felt something different. And that different feeling was the Holy Spirit inside of me, the Holy Spirit making a move inside of me. And it just, I don't know, it just made me happy ever since then. And then I always went to youth group. I always did things at church. I always never missed a day unless I had a basketball practice or something like that. Because ball is life, right, Damien?
Yeah.
Okay. And so I did that. And then I went to this one youth group that Jacob invited me. And at that youth group, I just had a 360-degree turn. Like, at that basketball practice, it was a 180-degree turn, but a 360-degree turn was at this youth group called Father's House. And at the Father's House, I just felt this one welcoming moment there, and I just felt this warmth that people had for me, and how the youth pastor there came up to me and said hi, and wanted to be my friend even though he didn't know me. So after that, I just felt so welcomed. I felt so comforted. I felt that I could do anything ever since then. And after that, I just went there. I couldn't stop going. I just always felt Jesus there. I always felt the presence of God. And now I'm praying over people. I'm speaking in tongues, and I'm helping people to become fishers of men like Jesus.